Namaste children, how are you all? I hope you understood that in the previous session class. Now let us discuss one more problem from the same vector. That is the same exercise 2.4, question number 4, first bit where we are going to explain that. What is that? Factorize 12x square minus 7x plus 1. See this here, this problem we are going to factorize by using splitting middle term and as well as the factor theorem also. By splitting middle term and as well as by using factor theorem also, we are going to factorize this quadratic polynomial. Now see this here, solution, given that p of x is equal to 12x square minus 7x plus 1. First of all, splitting middle term. By splitting middle term, we are going to factorize the given quadratic polynomial. Clear? So now, do you know that how to split middle term? First of all, you have to multiply the constant term with x square term. Okay? So now, see, 12x square minus 7x plus 1. I am going to multiply this constant term with 12x square, you will get 12x square because both are positive, right? By multiplying 1 into x square, 1 into 12x square will become 12x square. Now in this, what are the factor pairs of 12 to satisfy? Product is 12x square, sum is minus 7x. So now what are the factors I am going to write here? Okay, now plus r minus 1, plus r minus 12, clear? Plus r minus 2, plus r minus 6, plus r minus 3, plus r minus 4. These are the factor pairs to satisfy the product of 1 into 12 is 12, 2 6 are 12, and 3 4 are 12. But we want to get minus 7x. Sum should be minus 7x, product should be 12x square. What is that? Product is the product of two values will become 12x square and sum is minus 7x. So to satisfy out of these three pairs, I am going to take this third pair because 3 plus 4 equal to 7 and 3 fourth are 12. Okay, so now out of these three pairs we are going to select, we are going to consider plus r minus 3 and plus r minus 4. In that, plus 3 plus 4 or minus 3 minus 4, because the product of these two will become positive, plus 12x square, sum of these two values will become minus 7x. So, to get minus 7x, the sum should be minus 7x, you have to take both minus 3 and less minus 4. Clear? So now, which is implies 12x square minus 3x minus 4x plus 1. Clear my dears? Now which is implies here? In the first two terms, I am going to take minus 3x as the entirely common because 12 is a multiple of 3. If I take 3x is outside, if 3x is outside, it means common, the leftover part is here 4x, here minus 1. Now in the next two terms, I am going to take minus 1 as the common because I should get here plus 4x. To get plus 4x, you should take minus 1 as the common. So here 4x. Now in plus 1, minus 1 is outside, you will get minus 1 here. So the leftover part is 4x minus 1 is the common in the both terms. The leftover part is here 3x minus 1. So therefore, the entire polynomial p of x is nothing but, see, product of two linears, that is 4x minus 1 into 3x minus 1. Clear? So therefore the given polynomial 12x square minus 7x plus 1 can be written as product of two linears, that is 4x minus 1 into 3x minus 1. This is clear, my dears? See this here. To find the factors of this 12x square. You please write all the possibilities, all the factors of 12. You please write on factor pairs. In that, out of all the factor pairs, which pair is satisfying this condition? These both the conditions. That means product is 12x square. Sum is minus 7x. Clear, my dear sir? So after getting this, the values which are the factor pair, then you have to substitute in the place of middle value, middle term. That is minus 7x. Instead of minus 7x, we are going to write minus 3x and minus 4x, because minus 3 minus 4 is minus 7. Clear? And 3 into 4 is 12. X and x is x square. 12x square. So now take the common. Whatever the common you have in the first two terms and the next two terms, and finally you will get the answer is 12x square minus 7x plus 1 equal to 4x minus 1 into 3x minus 1. These are the factors. Now the same question we are going to use it by factor theorem also. We are going to factorize this 12x square minus 7x plus 1. Whether we are going to get the same factors or not, let us try. I hope you understood that how to a splitting method by factorize a given a quadratic polynomial. Okay. Now, let us see this here, children. The same question, 12x square minus 7x plus 1, we are going to factorize by using factor theorem also. Okay, now see, given that, let us take P of x is equal to 12x square minus 7x plus 1. So, we are going to factorize this quadratic polynomial by using factor theorem. By using factor theorem. Okay, now see this here. See, you have to take two values which satisfy the given quadratic polynomial. Let us take that. Before we take that, see this, I told you in the previous session, to factorize the quadratic polynomial by using factor theorem. See that the coefficient of x square must be 1. I want that the coefficient of x square is 1 only. Here 12 is there. So we need to remove 12. So it is not possible to remove the 12. You please take the common 12 as from entire polynomial. So then the p of x is equal to, by taking 12 is outside, in the first term if 12 is common, the leftover part is x square. Here there is no 12. So you should get 7x by 12. Okay, here also 12 is not there, so therefore 1 by 12 will get. If you multiply, you get the same thing. See, 12 into x square is 12x square minus 12 into 7x by 12. 12 will get cancel, you get 7x plus 12 into 1 by 12. 12 will get cancel. The leftover part is 1. So now this bracket part we are going to factorize by using factor theorem. So now let a comma b are the zeros of a p of x such that p of a equal to 0 and p of b is equal to 0, so then if p of a equal to 0, p of b equal to 0, by using factor theorem, x minus a is one of the factor and as well as x minus b also one of the factor. Then p of x is equal to, that is here in this 12 is there already, 12 into this bracket part can be written as x minus a into x minus b. We are going to find out a and b values. Clear? After finding a and b values, just substitute in that, you will get the solution. Clear? So now, provided the condition is 12 into x minus a into x minus b, where a into b is equal to 1 by 12. A into b is equal to 1 by 12. This is the product of zeros. Okay, a into b is equal to 1 by 12. So now we need to find out which values to satisfy the condition a into b is equal to 2, such that a and b values we need to take
a and b values are separately. To multiply both the values, you should get 1 by 12. Okay? Now, the possibilities are, since here, generally, you get 1 by 12. So, 1 by 2, 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. I think these are the only 4 values. Okay? Now, plus r minus 1 by 2, plus r minus 1 by 6, and comma, plus r minus 1 by 4, comma, plus r minus 1 by 3. So, these are the possibilities, sir. To multiply 1 by 2 into 1 by 6, you get 1 by 12. Even 1 by 4 into 1 by 3, you get 1 by 12. Now, let us take one value. Okay, so now p of 1 by 2 I am going to take that. Because this is a positive value, let us take 1 by 2. Substitute this 1 by 2 in this polynomial. In this, okay. Let us take equation number 1. Okay, from equation number 1, we are going to substitute 1 by 2 in the place of x. So 1 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 12 into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 12. Now which is implies 12 into, see, 1 by 2 whole square is nothing but 1 by 4 minus 7 by 24 plus 1 by 12. Now see this here, what is the LCM here? 4, 24 and 12. 24 is the LCM. So by taking 24 is as LCM, so therefore 4 is 6 minus 7 plus 2. Now see this here, 12, 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 minus 7 is 1, 1 by 12, sorry, 1 by 24 here. So therefore, 12 into 1 by 4, 24 is nothing but 12, 1 by 12, you will get 1 by 2, which is not at all equal to 0. When I substitute, I am taking one value, okay, because these two are one pair, 1 by 2 into 1 by 6 to satisfy 1 by 12. By multiplying this, you get 1 by 12. I am taking one value, I am substituting in the equation number 1, okay, whether it is 0 or not, I am going to find out. See, after substituting 1 by 2 in the place of x, I got not equal to 0, I got 1 by 2 only. So, 1 by 2 is not a 0, so p of 1 by 2 is not equal to 0, then automatically p of 1 by 6 also not equal to 0. Okay, now let us continue, please copy this. Now, see this here, 1 by 2 is not possible here, 1 by 2 p of 1 by 2 is not equal to 0 we got. So, obviously, you can see that 1 by 6 also, p of 1 by 6 also is not equal to 0. So, as we got 1 by 2 is not equal to 0, p of 1 by 2 is not equal to 0, then p of 1 by 6 is also not equal to 0. The next alternative is what? 1 by 4 and 1 by 3. Okay, so here I should get positive. Now both take positive or both are negative also. Okay, now let us take that start with positive value. Now I am going to take p of 1 by 3. So from the equation we are going to substitute in the place of x 1 by 3. What we are going to get? See this here. 12 into 1 by 3 whole square minus 7 by 12 into 1 by 3 plus 1 by 12. Now see this here, 12 into 1 by 3 whole square is nothing but what? 1 square, 3 square. So that is 1 by 9 minus 7 into 1 is 7 by 12, 3 is 36 plus 1 by 12. Now see, observe this here, what is the LCM for 9, 36 and 12? 36 is a multiple of 9 and the last 12. 9 4 is 12, 3 is. So therefore 36 is the LCM. So now, how do they find out here LCM? LCM of 9, 36 and 12. So by taking here 2, 9, 2, 18 is 2, 6 is 2, 9 is 2, 9 is 2, 3 is. Let us take 3, 3, 3 is 3, 3 is 3, 1 is again 3, 1, 1, 1. So 2 into the LCM is 2 into 3 into 3. Which is equal to 2 to the 4, 4 3 is a 12, 4 3 is a 36. Clear, my dears? So now, the value LCM of these three is nothing but how much? 36. So now 9 4s are 4 1s are 4 minus 36 into 36, 36 1s are, so 7 plus 12 3s are 36, 3 1s are 3. So which implies 12 into 7 minus 7 by 36, which is equal to how much it is? 12 into 0 by 36, we become 0. So we got here, therefore P of 1 by 3 is equal to 0 we got. Then automatically P of 1 by 4 also will become 0. So therefore, if P of 1 by 3 equal to 0 and as well as P of 1 by 4 also become 0. Sir, why? How you know that 1 by 4 is equal to 0? Because when we are multiplying with 1 by 3, with 1 by 4, derivative will get 1 by 12. If I take minus here, minus 1 by 4, plus 1 by 3 into minus 1 by 4 become minus 1 by 12. But I want to get the product of A and B will become 1 by 12. So here, P of 1 by 3 we got 0, we proved here. Then automatically you can say that P of 1 by 4 equal to 0. So this is A value, this is B value. Just substituting that. Okay. So therefore, now after getting P of 1 by 3 and P of 1 by 4, now our body polynomial will become, so P of x is equal to, so here, so therefore we got P of 1 by 3 equal to 0 and as well as P of 1 by 4 also equal to 0. So therefore P of x is equal to 12 into x minus 1 by 3 into x minus 1 by 4. Clear? Now which is implies, which is equal to, now take the LCM in this bracket, x by 1, LCM is 3, 3 into x, 3x, minus 1, into here 4 is the LCM, so 4 into x is 4x, minus 1 by, now see this here, 12 into 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1, by multiplying these two 3 4s are 12, this 12 term will get it cancelled. The entire polynomial will become 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1. So therefore, the polynomial, given polynomial can be written as P of x is equal to what we got, 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1. So therefore, 12x square minus 7x plus 1 can be written as 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1. Clear? This is your answer to factorize the given quadratic polynomial 12x square minus 7x plus 1 can be written as 3x minus 1 into 4x minus 1. By splitting middle term also we got same answers. So this is the process to factorize the given quadratic polynomial by using factor theorem. I hope you understood that. The remaining two questions you need to do homework. Okay? Right, children, till now we discussed how to factorize a quadratic polynomial. Okay, let us move to the how to factorize a cubic polynomial or fourth degree polynomial or any higher degree polynomial. So before going to discuss that, see this here, for example, I am going to wrote on the board, factorize x cube minus 23x square plus 142x minus 120. So here, we need not using splitting middle term. See, because here there are two terms are there, you cannot split these two terms. Clear? But here, by using factor theorem, you can factorize this cubic polynomial or fourth degree polynomial or fifth degree polynomial also. So before that, I want to tell you one notation. See, already we discussed in the factor theorem, if x minus a is a factor, then P of a equal to 0. What we discussed in the previous session, if x minus a is a factor, then compulsory P of a must be 0. Clear? So here, suppose if x minus 1 is a factor, I am taking that if x minus 1 is a factor,
then compulsory P of 1 must be 0. Clear? Just now we discussed P of A equal to 0, P of B equal to 0, then x minus A into x minus B are the factors. Clear? So same thing, but how we know that 1 is a factor of given polynomial, means x minus 1 is a factor of a given polynomial, or 1 is satisfied in the place of x becomes 0. If you substitute x equal to 1 in the given polynomial, is it 0 or not? How we know that? That is trial and error method. But we cannot apply every time trial and error method. Okay, there is a simple shortcut, one note point is there. You please write down that note point. Clear? That is, whenever you take this cubic polynomial or 4 degree polynomial or 5th degree polynomial, this is possible. Okay, now see this here. Solution, given that P of x is equal to x cube minus 23x square plus 142x minus 120. Now what I am going to do that, I am taking all the coefficients of x cube, x square, x including constant value. I am going to add all those. What is that? I am going to take all the coefficients of x cube, x square, x and as well as constant value including its sign. Now I am going to add all the values, all the numerical values. If it becomes 0, then compulsory x minus 1 is one of the factor. See this here. What I am going to take that term? See, note point term. You please write down. Sum of the coefficients of sum of the coefficients of all the terms is 0, then x minus 1 is one of the factor. Now see this, you please note down this note point. Sum of the coefficients of all the terms of x. Clear? Now see this here. I am going to take all the coefficients of x cube, x square, x and a constant term. The coefficient of x cube is 1 here. The coefficient of x square is minus 23. The coefficient of x is plus 142. And the constant term is minus 120. By adding all the coefficients of x, means x cube, x square, x and LS constant value, what is it will become? The value will become, see this here, 1 plus 142 is 143, minus 120 minus 23 is minus 143. So both will become 0. By adding all the coefficients of x cube, x square, x and constant term, okay, the value becomes 0. So then directly we can say that x minus 1 is one of the factor. X minus 1 is one of the factor. So here, therefore we can say that x minus 1 is one of the factor of P of x. That is P of 1 equal to 0. So therefore, here I got x minus 1 is one of the factor. Now this I want to split it by this 23x square and another 140x also to get as x minus 1 as the common. See what I am going to do that. Now after getting x minus 1, now you need to find out the factors of minus 120. Now the factors of factor pairs. Factors of 120. In every problem, we need to find out the factors of the constant value, compulsory. Now, what are the factors of 120? See, less or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4, and otherwise, plus or minus 5, plus or minus 6. Okay, now, after 6, we have plus or minus 8, plus or minus 10, plus or minus 12, plus or minus 15. The next is plus or minus 20, because 26 are right. Now 15 is are. Now the left hand part is plus or minus 24 plus or minus 30 and plus or minus 60. So these are the possibilities. These are the factors of 120. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 20, 24, 30, and the rest 60 also. Clear? These are the factors of 120. Now, in this we got p of 1 equal to 0. So, in this, so that p of 1 equal to 0. That means x minus 1 is one of the factor we got. Now, to simplify these two terms, to get as x minus 1 as the common, how we are going to splitting these terms? See this here. Observe clearly here. This is very important step. The given polynomial is x cube minus 23x square plus 142x minus 120. Now, I am going to change these two terms. How I am going to change? Let us see this here. X cube minus, see, I want to get here x minus 1. To get x minus 1, you should write x square only. From minus 23x square, I wrote 1x square here. The leftover part is minus 22x square. Clear? Now, in first two terms, if I take x square as the common, you get x minus 1. Now, in this also, the next two terms also, if I take the common, I should get x minus 1 as the factor. See this here. Minus 22x square. Now, in this 142x, here 120 is there. So, if it is 120, here also it should be 120x. So, out of 142, if I take 120 as the side, the leftover part is 22x here. So, here, plus 22x, I am writing plus 120x minus 120. Keep it in mind here. This is totally mind calculations. You please concentrate, listen carefully. We should get x minus 1 as a factor in entire value. Okay, that's why our convenient, we are going to split this 23x square as a minus x square, minus 22x square. And this 142x also, with the help of 120, I am going to take 22 and less 120. Okay, now, which is implies, here x cube, here x square, 1x square as the common. If I take x square as the common, the leftover part here is x, here minus 1. Now, in between these two, here 22x is there, here 22x square is there. So, I am going to take a minus 22x as the common. If I take minus 22x as the common, you will get here x, here minus 1. Clear? Now, see this here, minus 22x into x is minus 22x square, minus into minus plus, 22x into 1 equal 22x. Now, here, plus, both are here plus, here minus is there, but I should get minus 1. So now, I am going to take 120 as the common. If I take 120 as the common, you will get x minus 1. Now, see this here, in each and every term, we have x minus 1. Here x minus 1 is there, here x minus 1 is there, here x minus 1 is there. So take x minus 1 as a common, the leftover part is x square minus 22x plus 120. Now, the given quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, can be written as product of a linear and a quadratic polynomial. This quadratic polynomial we are going to, by splitting middle term, we are going to factorize by splitting middle term. For that reason, we wrote the factors of 120 here. Okay, these factors we are going to use here. Clear, my dears? Now, please note down this one. We are going to explain that. So, finally, here we got p of x can be written as, which is implies p of x can be written as x minus 1 into x square minus 1 to x plus 120. We got as a product of a linear and as a quadratic polynomial. Now, we are going to factorize the quadratic polynomial. We get the remaining two factors. Okay? Now, can I erase this? Right numbers. So, here, change is here. So finally we got that. What we got here? X minus 1. So now P of x is equal to, we got x minus 1 into x square minus 22 x plus 120. Now factorize this quadratic polynomial. Okay. Now factorize x square minus 22 x plus 120. Same, multiply 120 x square constant term into x square term. Okay. Now, what are the factors of 120? We wrote here already. So, what are the factors of 120? Even here, 120 also will get plus or minus 120 because 1 into 120 is 120. Now, 40 also will get 340s also. Here I have plus or minus 40 also will get 340s are 120. Right now. So, which pair will going to satisfy? The product is 120 x square and sum should be minus 22 x here. So now, see this here, to satisfy minus 22, which one we are going to take that? 10 into 12, because 10 plus 12 equal to 22 and 10 12 are 120. Clear? Is there any other? No, only those two are. So therefore, we are going to do 10x square plus 10x and 12x. 10x and 12x. Here I should get positive, here I should get negative. So 22 is a bigger number than these two. So keep the minus for both the values. Keep the minus for both the values. Because minus into minus is plus 10 12 is 120, x into x is x square. Minus 10x, minus 12x. By adding these two, you will get minus 22. I am going to write the product is 120 x square and sum should be minus 22 x. Clear? So now that value we are going to substitute here. Now which is implies x square minus 10x minus 12x plus 120. Now which is implies by taking x as the common, you will get x minus 10. Here in between these two, minus 4 as the common, x minus 10. So therefore, by simplifying, x minus 10 is the common, the leftover part is x minus 12. These are the two factors for this bracket, this part, quadratic polynomial. So here one more is there, this one and these two. These three are the factors of a given polynomial x cube minus 23 x square plus 142x minus 120. Because it is a cubic polynomial, it has three zeros. So therefore, the given polynomial P of x can be written as x minus 1 into x minus 10 into x minus 12. Clear, my dears? So therefore, under the given polynomial, x cube minus 23 x square plus 142 x minus 120 is equal to x minus 1 into x minus 10 into x minus 12. Okay, these are the three factors of a given cubic polynomial, x cube minus 23 x square plus 142 x minus 120 can be written as product of x minus 1, x minus 10 and x minus 12. This is a way to factorize a cubic polynomial or fourth degree polynomial or any above the means that the fifth degree polynomial or any degree polynomial. See that first of all you have to verify by adding all the coefficients of x and less 120. That constant amounts. That is the coefficient of x cube, coefficient of x square, coefficient of x and the last constant value. By adding all these values, if it becomes 0, then x minus 1 is one of the factor. So keep it in mind, to simplify the given quadratic cubic polynomial, we should get x minus 1 as the factor in each and every term. See, in this term x minus 1 is the common, here x minus 1 is the common, here also x minus 1 is the common. Like that, you need to split the middle terms, you need to separate the middle terms to get x minus 1 as the factor. Okay, I hope you understood that. Let us discuss. Okay, right, children. I hope you understood that about to factorize a cubic polynomial. Okay, now here is your homework. Textbook page number 44, exercise 2.4, question number 4, third bit and fourth bit. Question number 5, first question. Please complete this homework and please send to my WhatsApp number. It is in a group only. Okay, I hope you understood that. Thank you, everyone.